Hello, stock friends, and welcome to your daily stock report brought to you by QualityStocks.net, where performance is tracked daily. I'm Kathy Rankin, and for Friday, January 19th, we're bringing you the latest news from around the markets as well as the top movers to look out for today. In our headline news, stocks picked up Thursday where they left off a session earlier, trading lower, taking a hit from another sell-off in technology. The NASDAQ plunged 1.5%, its biggest one-day decline in nearly 2 months. Oil prices plunging to 20-month lows also removed some notable leadership, while more evidence the Fed is not likely to ease anytime soon also weighed on sentiment and left valuations vulnerable. Tech, which was this year's best-performing S&P 500 sector at plus 3.9% just 2 days ago, plunged again after disappointing second-quarter guidance from Apple overshadowed its blowout report. Apple, which closed at a record high on Tuesday, handily topped Wall Street expectations last night, prompting several brokers to raise their price targets. The market was also preoccupied with some commentary from Federal Chairman Bernanke just after the market opened. He warned of a possible fiscal crisis and added that if early and meaningful action is not taken to lower the budget deficit, the U.S. economy could be seriously weakened. Even though his testimony made no mention of monetary policy, a market more sensitive right now to negative news, especially from the most influential of Fed officials, acted as an overhang throughout the session. In our small cap headlines today, Perihelion Global announced that the Covington County Economic Development Commission and the state of Alabama jointly announced the official groundbreaking of the company's global biofuel refinery located in Op, Alabama on Monday, January 29, 2007. The groundbreaking will formally launch construction of Perihelion's biofuel refinery, which will be the largest of its kind in North America using peanuts as the primary stock, and will also be the third largest biofuel refinery in North America overall. Perihelion Global, PHGI, previously at 24 cents a share, opens this morning up 58% or 38 cents a share, with a little over a half a million shares traded by yesterday's close. Douglas Lake Minerals Incorporated, or DLKM, announced today its joint venture partner Canaco Resources provided an update on the progress of the Phase 1 exploration of its Morogoro property located in the Coloso District of Tanzania. Based on the preliminary results, it was determined that the majority of the gold at Morogoro is supergene secondary reprecipitate. Simply stated, this means that the gold is at the surface, easy to recover, and inexpensive to process. Douglas Lake Minerals Incorporated also announced today that the company has successfully acquired 4 Tanzanian uranium properties that cover an area of approximately 500 square kilometers. Previously at $1.10 a share, Douglas Lake opens up 22% today, or $1.35 a share. And that's it for the newsmakers. Be sure to join us every market day for the latest commentary on small cap to large cap and everything in between, brought to you by QualityStocks.net. Also, be sure to look for the Quality Stocks daily newsletter, available each trading day through QualityStocks.net. Thanks for tuning in. I'm Kathy Rankin. We'll see you here again tomorrow, right here on the Daily Report.
This transmission is coming to you.
We've got it.